2 Timothy 3, verse 1. But understand this, that in the last days there will come times of difficulty, for people will be lovers of self, lovers of money, proud, arrogant, abusive, disobedient to their parents, ungrateful, unholy, heartless, unappeasable, slanderous, without self-control, brutal, not loving good, treacherous, reckless, swollen with conceit, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having the appearance of godliness but denying its power. Avoid such people. For among them are those who creep into households and capture weak women, burdened with sins and led astray by various passions, always learning and never able to arrive at a knowledge of the truth, just as Jannes and Jambres opposed Moses, so these men also oppose the truth, men corrupted in mind and disqualified regarding the faith. But they will not get very far, for their folly will be plain to all, as was that of those two men. You, however, have followed my teaching, my conduct, my aim in life, my faith, my patience, my love, my steadfastness, my persecutions and sufferings that happened to me at Antioch and Iconium and at Lystra, which persecutions I endured. Yet from them all the Lord rescued me. Indeed, all who desire to live a godly life in Christ Jesus will be persecuted, while evil people and impostors will go on from bad to worse, deceiving and being deceived. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and have firmly believed, knowing from whom you learned it, and how from childhood you have been acquainted with the sacred writings, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All Scripture is breathed out by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, for training in righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, equipped for every good work. We all need encouragement, especially in difficult times. We all need encouragement to continue in the faith, especially during fearful times. Paul is writing to Timothy to strengthen his faith. The second letter to Timothy is an encouraging letter to make Timothy aware of life as a disciple of Jesus. Paul has encouraged Timothy to not be ashamed, but to use his gifts that he has been given. But in chapter 3, Paul wants to tell Timothy and us what life will be like in the last days. In verse 1, Paul tells Timothy that he needs to understand that in the last days, there will be difficult times. People sometimes speak of the last days as something yet to come in the future. But in the Scriptures, the last days refer to the age of Christ and the time that followed. The writer of Hebrews states that he was living in the last days. In Hebrews chapter 1, verses 1 and 2, the Hebrew writer says, "Long ago, at many times and in many ways, God spoke to our fathers by the prophets. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son, whom he appointed the heir of all things, through whom also he created the world." When Paul tells Timothy about trouble and difficulty in the last days, he's not pointing to something more than 2,000 years away. Rather, Timothy was already living in the last days. We continue to live in the last days and will remain in the last days until the return of Jesus. So here is Paul's starting point. It is going to be hard to live as a Christian during the last days. It is not going to be comfortable or easy. There are going to be hard and terrible times for those who are trying to follow Jesus. So why is this going to be hard for the people of God? Paul explains the reason in verses 2 down to all the way down to verse 9. Now, as you read the list of sins that Paul points to that people will be committing here, you'll notice that Paul is not talking about the condition of the sinful world. That's not who he's talking about here, because the list of sins are always true for those who do not belong to Jesus. There's nothing surprising about any of these characteristics when talking about sinful people. These things are true about everyone who has ever lived in defiance of the Lord. The reason why these are going to be difficult times is because they are going to be people among us who claim to be followers of Jesus, but are instead practicing these things and have these characteristics. Now, consider these descriptions as Paul speaks about false followers of Jesus. The first description is that they are lovers of self. They claim to love God, but they do not. They love themselves. They love money. They are proud and boastful. They are arrogant. They are abusive and demeaning. They are disobedient to their parents. They are ungrateful. They are unholy. They are heartless. They are unappeasable and unforgiving. They are slanderers. They are without self-control. They are brutal and cruel. They do not love good. They betray their friends. They are rash and reckless. They are puffed up with pride. They love pleasure. They act religious, having an appearance of devotion to God. Now, I love the strong words of verse 5. I've highlighted them for you. Avoid such people. Timothy, Paul says to you, very plain in three short words, avoid such people. Avoid fake Christians. Now, why should they be avoided? The answer is that they are dangerous. Fake Christians are dangerous people. In verses 6 through 9, we see why they are dangerous. Verse 6, we see that they take advantage of people. They worm their way into relationships and homes, targeting people who feel guilty and weighed down by their sins and take advantage of them. Avoid these people because they are dangerous. They will make a way into your life only to take advantage of you. In verse 7, Paul stops and warns about these who are being taken advantage of. Paul says that they are always learning, but are never able to draw a conclusion or to take a stand in the scriptures. Their knowledge does not do them any good whatsoever. They are always learning, but they are never doing. Paul says that false followers are not doers. They listen and listen, but it never changes them, and it never causes them to act on what they have heard. Then in verse 8, Paul returns to the description of these people who are needing to be avoided. And notice that he notes that they will ultimately oppose the truth. They are corrupted in mind and worthless in the faith. But there is something interesting about these false followers that Paul describes in verse 9. Paul says that they did not get very far because their folly became plain to all. Time reveals those who are false. You can only be fake for so long. The behaviors that are listed in verses 2 through 5 eventually will come out. The consequences of those behaviors also will become evident. Your life is going to blow up living this way. Now, why is Paul telling Timothy these things? Well, notice what Paul tells Timothy in verses 10 through 13. Paul says that you have followed my life. You have seen my suffering. You know what I have gone through. Everyone who wants to live a godly life will be persecuted. In short, these false followers are going to hurt you. You need to watch out for them and avoid them. But these false followers are part of the reason for Paul's suffering. Know that living in the last days means that this is going to happen to you from others who claim to be followers of Jesus. It is going to happen from the people you thought you could trust because they claim to follow Jesus. But do not let them shake your faith. Look at verse 13. Paul says evil will continue and it will not get any better. It is not going to stop. It has happened to you before. It'll happen to you again. Evil will only continue. People who are false will never stop coming along. Avoid them. They are dangerous. Now, what should Timothy do as he lives in the last days? What should we do as we live in the last days? How are we going to continue forward in faith when we have all these difficult days that we must expect to have happen to us? Well, look at verses 14 through 17. Continue in the teachings you have heard and learned. Depend on the teachings from the scriptures as you walk through these difficult times. And listen to what he says in verse 15. The sacred writings are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. Do not be shaken by those who are false. Do not give up your faith because of the false faith of others. Continue in what you have learned. continue in the teachings from the sacred writings. It is the teachings from the sacred writings that'll make you wise for salvation. Now consider that when Paul writes to Timothy, the sacred writings would have been the Hebrew scriptures. The sacred writings at this point in history would have been Genesis through Malachi, what we call the Old Testament. But notice what Paul says. Those books are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Jesus. Did you know that every book in the Old Testament doesn't just tell you interesting stories about people in the past or about the nation of Israel? Every book in the Old Testament is able to make you wise for salvation and bring you to faith in Jesus. How sad it is that these 39 books are so frequently neglected. But those books have just as much saving power and just as much of an ability to grow and strengthen your faith like the New Testament books do. And if you don't believe me, we'll just skip down to verses 16 and 17. All scripture is breathed out by God. Breathed out is the word inspired. Every book, every word comes out of God's mouth. And the people of God, carried by the Holy Spirit, like the apostles and prophets, wrote them down. 2 Peter 1, verses 20 and 21. Not only this, but all of God's word is beneficial for teaching, rebuke, correction, and for training in righteousness. When we come to the word of God, this is what we are looking at. We are reading to be taught, to be rebuked, to be corrected, to be trained in righteousness. The word teaches us. The word exposes our sins. The word corrects our direction. The word trains us in the right way to live. Here's the purpose, verse 17, so that we can be complete and equipped for every good work. Paul told Timothy earlier that we are to cleanse ourselves so we can be an instrument for honorable use, set apart, useful to the master, and prepared for every good work. The way this preparation happens is by going to the scriptures. Now it seems just so simple. It does not seem magical enough for our liking. But the way for us to stand during difficult times in the last days, dealing with the hurt inflicted from false followers, and maintaining our faith while being persecuted for living a godly life, is to continue in and firmly believe the sacred scriptures that'll make you wise for salvation. The scriptures are from God's mouth and will make you complete. Nothing else will. We sometimes try to energize our faith by doing just about anything and everything else except spending time in God's word and holding on to the teachings. How are we to be strong in the faith during the last days? How can we maintain our faith during difficult times? You need to ground your life and spend your time in God's word daily. There is no other answer. Our elders at Eastside have selected for our theme this year, Hebrews 11 and verse 1, that faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. That scripture reminds us of the power of faith and the evidence of scripture that God has provided for us. And not only that, but the assurance that we have that we are on the right path because we have God's word for us, written by inspired men, by the Holy Spirit, given to us by God, God breathed. Living in the last days, we need God's word flowing through our hearts like oxygen in our lungs, so we can be found faithful and approved by God. Well, that concludes chapter 3. Next time, 2 Timothy chapter 4. Looking forward to concluding this letter and Paul's last letter in the New Testament next time. Thank you so much. Have a great and wonderful day.